What up? It's the troopers.
Hey!
What up?
It's the troopers.
I was tucking in my shirt.
That's a good idea. All right, it's Saturday. Sabado.
Sing it.
No. Lady Trooper and I are, I'm on the strip to play poker. Lady Trooper's on the strip to announce. Can you understand how, now do you see it for yourself, people waving at the back of the camera? Did you see them waving?
No, I didn't.
You didn't see that lady right there waving at, no one sees it but me. She was photobombing the back of the camera.
Oh gosh. They must do it all the time to me and I never realize it.
Maybe. You'll probably notice it from now on, but we have an announcement to make. Brace yourselves. It's the new Sparkly Pops. All right, one of the toughest pops to make so far.
Yes, it was.
What's the new flavor? If you remember, our favorite non-coffee drink from Starbucks is mango dragon fruit lemonade. Christina Dunn made a pop.
Made it into a pop.
Made it into a pop.
It took a month to come out with this.
Yeah, a whole bunch of juice and sugar trying to get the flavor right.
Yeah.
It's got actual dragon fruit in it, mango, lemon, all that stuff.
You said mango, right?
Yeah.
Mango, lemon, lime. You see the little specks of dragon fruit in it.
Mango dragon fruit lemonade. Can you believe it? Our favorite drink into a pop. Wait a minute, only only mango dragon fruit lemonade?
Nope, white grape.
White grape?
Yep.
Oh snap. Windy today. Look at, there goes Lady Trooper. There she goes. Bye, Lady Trooper. Bye. Sparkly Pop action. Mango, dragon fruit, lemonade. As previously mentioned, it's Saturday. You can kind of tell by how busy the strip is. Oh, it's a Saturday. Lady Trooper was so excited about the new mango dragon fruit lemonade sparkling pops that she just had to come down to the strip so we could tell you about it. 3:21 in the PM. I am on the list at Horseshoe. Oh, look at that. The Horseshoe's just right there. See, I'm not the only one that don't want any damn tomato on there, whatever that was on. Lady Trooper had a pretty clever idea. She was like, you know, you should do the worst burgers on the strip. Wahlburgers would definitely be in that collection. Because Wahlburgers is probably the worst burger in Vegas, maybe the world. I don't know. I said it, Marky Mark. But as good of an idea as that is, it means I would have to actually go purchase burgers that I know to be horrible and then figure out which one is the worst. Kind of feels like a waste of money. I may still do it, but Wahlburgers, it's gonna be up there. I would probably do Wahlburgers. You know what? I'll keep it a secret just in case I do it, but Wahlburgers for sure. I wonder if he can feel the vibration of what I just said. Feel the vibration. Come on, come on. Just boring. Doesn't matter how many tables you play at, it's just difficult some nights to find a good game. I was in two games and they both pretty well sucked. It was extremely dull, boring. I lose $67 and what are you gonna do? There comes a point where, for me at least, I just get to a point where I'm like, yeah, I'm over this. You know what I mean? You know, you may have heard me say in the past that this area here in front of the Bellagio fountain, so the sidewalk out front of the Bellagio from the north edge of the fountains to the south edge of the fountains. You may have heard me say in the past that that is my favorite part of the strip. And I mean, it's always been my favorite, like, bit of sidewalk on the entire strip, going all the way back to 2007. But it has become so overrun with street performers and people selling shit and little, like, weird, there must have been 10 different, I don't know what the hell it is. There's some kind of shit they have set up that the camera spins around you and takes like some crazy, like, 360 picture video or whatever. There must have been like 10 of those. And then at another point, it was completely overrun with homeless people sleeping all along that whole area out there with tents and shit. I can no longer call it my favorite part of the strip. Wow, look at a parade of little trucks. And you know, it's a shame. For me, it's a shame. Because I love that part of the strip, but it's just gotten so shitty that I don't even like to walk down that part of the strip anymore. And I know what you're thinking, Trooper, why are you being so negative? You know, I don't really mean to be negative. It's hard to remember what Vegas was like, even when I got here in 2014. So much shit is different. Pizza that I used to love sucks. Coffee that I used to be okay with sucks. Poker rooms that I like to play in, closed. I mean, I guess this is sort of the way all of life goes. People wave at the back of the camera, it never stops. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. I'll see you next time.